Now understand the question. I am reading the question. A 75 kg person stands on a weighing scale in an elevator. So here I have shown an elevator. In this elevator there will be a weighing scale, and on that weighing scale a person is standing. Weight of the person, mass of the person is given here, 75 kg. 3 seconds after the motion starts from rest. What is meaning of this? U is equal to 0, initial velocity. And what is the time given? 3 seconds. The tension in the hoisting cable was found to be 8300 newton. So this is the elevator. This elevator will have a hoisting cable. Okay, now this cable, it is connected to the pulley and there will be motor arrangement so that lift can be operated. Okay, now in the hoisting cable, what is the tension? 8300 newton. Okay, next, find the reading of scale in kg during this interval. Okay, so we need to find what is the value of kg. Okay, mass of the person we have to find out. Then also find the velocity of elevator at the end of this interval. Okay, so we have to find what is the velocity when time is 3 seconds. Okay, this is first part. The total mass of elevator including mass of person and weighing scale is 750 kg. Okay, now here this is the elevator, here there will be weighing scale and here there will be a person. Okay, weight of all these things, okay, all including elevator, mass of the person and weighing scale, it is 750 kg. Okay, so that is why here you can see I have shown in downward direction weight 750 into 9.81. if the elevator is now moving in opposite direction with same magnitude of acceleration, what will be new reading of the scale? Okay, now understand that first case it is not given, but here we will assume that lift is moving in upward direction. Okay, so that is why here you can see acceleration I have shown in upward direction. So I'll write down, first we have to calculate what? First we have to calculate velocity. Okay, now this velocity, which equation we have to use? V is equal to u plus at. In this equation velocity we have to find out. U is 0. Why? Because motion starts from rest. Then acceleration, this part we will get from D'Alembert's principle. Okay, and time, it is given in question. So we will first apply D'Alembert's principle. So I'll write down, using D'Alembert's principle. Okay, now in which direction we have acceleration? In x direction or y direction? Okay, x direction we don't have any motion, so we have to use in y direction. Okay, so this D'Alembert's principle we have to apply in y direction. So I'll write down summation Fy. What is this? Summation of all the forces in y direction and in the direction of motion we have to consider positive. Okay, so upward will be positive and downward forces will be negative, plus inertia force, which is minus ma, equal to 0. Okay, now this ay will be, acceleration will be ay because it is in y direction. Okay, now summation of all the forces. So understand the FBD part. Here we are considering that elevator, it is traveling in upward direction. Okay, so acceleration is upward direction. So inertia force, it will be in downward direction. What is magnitude of inertia force? Mass into acceleration. So mass is 750 kg. It is mass of elevator including mass of person and weighing scale. That is that 750 kg. Okay, so 750 into A, that will be inertia force. So I'll write down the equation. Now here in FBD I have shown tension in upward direction. Why? Because there will be a cable like this. Okay, it is suppose on the pulley like this. Okay, so this cable, if you draw the FBD, it is being pulled, elevator is being pulled in upward direction. Okay, so this tension will be like this. Even if elevator is traveling in downward direction, na, tension will be same. Okay, it will be in upward direction only for the elevator side. Okay, so I'll write down summation Fy, it will be plus 8300, then minus of this weight value, minus 750 into 9.81, minus inertia force, which is 750 into Ay, equal to 0. So from here I can calculate acceleration in y direction, Ay, equal to 1.256 meter per second square. Okay, now acceleration, it is in upward direction. Now what is the question asked? We have to find velocity of the elevator at the end of this interval, meaning 3 seconds. Okay, so what is asked? B is asked. Okay, initial velocity is 0 and time is given as 3 seconds. And Ay value we have calculated. What is that? 1.256 meter per second square. Okay, so we can apply that equation. V is equal to U plus At. Okay, V is equal to U is 0 plus acceleration in y direction 1.256 into time is 3 seconds. So from here I can calculate velocity. Velocity is equal to 3.768 meter per second. Okay, this was the question which is asked. Now next question, it is also asked to calculate the reading of the scale. Okay, here there will be a weighing scale in kg during this interval. Okay, so now lift is moving in upward direction and we have to calculate what is the reading on weighing scale in kg. Okay, so I'll write down reading on weighing scale if elevator moves upward. Now understand this part. Here I have shown FBD of a person. Okay, so here a person is there who is standing on the weighing scale. Okay, now there will be a reaction at the point of contact. Okay, here this will be reaction will be perpendicular. This reaction, it will be given by weighing scale. Okay, now when lift is moving, elevator is moving in upward direction. Direction of motion is upward, so acceleration is in upward direction. Acceleration value we have already calculated, Ay. Okay, now since lift is moving in upward direction, elevator, inertia force will be in downward direction. Now when we are trying to calculate, when we are calculating the weight shown by the weighing scale, we have to consider the weight of the person. And what is the weight of the person given in the question? 75 kg. Okay, so weight of the person, it will be 75 into 9.81 newton. Okay, and inertia force, it is opposite to the direction of motion. What will be that? Mass into acceleration. Mass is 75 kg into acceleration is A. Okay, so we'll apply D'Alembert's principle now. Summation Fy plus inertia force is equal to 0. Okay, now what is the direction of motion? Upward. So all the forces in upward direction will be positive. Okay, so plus R minus 75 into 9.81 minus inertia force 75 into Ay. What is that Ay value? 1.256 equal to 0. So from here we can calculate the reaction, okay, given by the weighing scale. So that will be the weight of the person. So R is equal to 829.95 newton. Now it is asked in the question to find in kg. Okay, so R is equal to 829.95 divided by 9.81. So R value we will get in kg. Okay, it is 84.6 kg. Now what is this value which we have calculated? If elevator moves in upward direction, even though actual weight of the person it is 75 kg, because of the motion, what is the weight of the person shown on the weighing scale? 84.6 kg, that we have calculated. Okay, now second part we will see. What is the second part of the question? If the elevator is now moving in opposite direction, meaning motion is in downward direction, okay, so acceleration will be downward direction, inertia force will be upward direction. With same magnitude of acceleration, and that magnitude we have already calculated here. Okay, so acceleration is remaining same. What will be new reading of the scale? Okay, so we'll consider the second case now. What is that case? Reading on weighing scale if elevator moves downward. Okay, now in this case again we have to apply D'Alembert's principle. Okay, summation of all the forces in y direction plus inertia force is equal to zero. Okay, now see the FBD. This is the person who is standing on the weighing scale, so there will be reaction from the weighing scale. Okay, now elevator, it is moving in downward direction, so acceleration is in downward direction, and inertia force, it is in upward direction. Weight of the person, mass is given as 75 kg. Okay, so weight will be 75 into 9.81. so I'll write down summation of all the forces in y direction, but in the direction of motion, that we have to consider positive. So in this case weight will be positive, so plus 75 into 9.81. R is upward, opposite to direction of motion, so minus R, and inertia force is also opposite, so minus 75 into AY. Acceleration in Y direction, it is 1.256 equal to 0. So we can calculate R. R is equal to 641.55 Newton. Okay, now divide this by 9.81. Okay, so 641.55 divided by 9.81. This will give answer in kg. Okay, so R is equal to 65.39 kg. Now what this indicates? When elevator, it is moving in upward direction, okay, against gravity. In that case, what is the original weight of the person, mass of the person? It is 75 kg. Okay, so because of the upward motion of the elevator, what is the mass of the person shown? 84.6 kg. Okay, and when elevator is moving in downward direction, okay, it is in the direction of gravity. Okay, in that case, mass of the person is 65.39 kg. Next numerical. Okay, now in this case, this is a type of numerical, different type of numerical as compared to previous one. Okay, these are problems on pulleys with fixed center. So here you can see a diagram has been given. This is given in the question. So there is an inclined surface which is at an angle of 45 degree, and then vertical. Okay, now block A, it is in contact with this incline. There is a pulley over here and a string is there. This string is inextensible, and at the end of the pulley here, block B is connected. So we have two blocks, A and B. Okay, we'll go through the question. Two blocks A and B connected as shown in figure. The string is inextensible. Mass of A and B are 3 kg and 5 kg respectively. So MA is 3 kg and MB is 5 kg. If the coefficient of friction between A and inclined plane is 0.25, so I'll write down that data here only. Mu is equal to 0.25 at this location. Determine the tension on the string. Okay, now here you can see the string is there, and since this string it is being pulled by block B in downward direction. Okay, and there is a resistance to the string in this direction also. There will be tension in the string. So that tension on the string we have to find out. And also we have to find accelerations of block A and block B. So what will be our approach? We will consider FBD of block A first and then block B. So I have shown FBD of block A over here. Understand that? Now string, it is being pulled in this direction. Okay, so tension will be towards right when you consider FBD of block A. Okay, so block A, it is being pulled towards right side. So that is why tension is towards right. Okay, so this is the block and the tension direction I have shown, it is towards right. So because of the tension, what will be the direction of motion of block A? It will be down the slope. So here you can see I have shown acceleration. Okay, and this will be the direction of motion of block A. Then weight of the block we have to consider. Now mass is 3 kg of block A. So weight will be 3 into 9.81. Now here you can observe this orange line. This is parallel to incline. And this one, NA, it is perpendicular to incline. Okay, now angle between incline and horizontal, this is 45. So perpendicular to incline is this normal reaction, and perpendicular to horizontal, this weight is there. So here angle is 45. So angle between this will also be 45. So that is why here you can see angle has been shown 45 degree. Okay, next, since motion is towards right, inertia force is towards left. What will be the magnitude of inertia force? Mass into acceleration. Mass is 3 kg into acceleration A. Okay, now motion is towards right. So friction force will be opposite to the direction of motion. Okay, so this will be friction force 0.25 Na. And what is Na? Na is normal reaction offered by the inclined plane to this block. Okay, so this angle is 90 degree. So this is about FBD of block A. Now if you consider directions over here, okay, we'll define the direction. This is positive X and this is positive Y. Okay, now X, it is parallel to the incline. Okay, this X is parallel to incline and Y, it is perpendicular to incline. Okay, now in this case, we have acceleration along X direction. Okay, and we don't have acceleration along Y direction. Okay, so in Y direction, we can use condition of equilibrium, which is what? Summation Fy is equal to zero. Now, upward forces, we have to consider positive. This is positive. And downward forces, we are considering negative. Okay, upward forces plus Na. Then weight is having a downward component. It will be like this if you resolve. So it will be minus 3 into 9.81 and angle is with respect to Y. So it will be cos 45. So minus 3 into 9.81 into cos 45 equal to 0. So from here I can calculate Na. Na is equal to 20.81 newton. Now once we know value of Na, we can calculate friction force so that we can apply D'Alembert's principle. Okay, so we'll apply D'Alembert's principle using D'Alembert's principle. What I can write? Summation of all the forces in X direction plus inertia force in X direction equal to zero. Okay, now what is the direction of motion? Direction of motion is this one. Okay, so all the forces towards this direction we have to consider positive. So plus T, then what is X component of weight? Okay, this will be X component of weight. Okay, it is in the direction of motion. So it will be plus. Plus 3 into 9.81 इनटू साइन 45, ओके, एंड इनर्शिया फोर्स इट इज ऑपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, सो माइनस 3 इनटू एक्स, और वी विल राइट ए. देन फ्रिक्शन फोर्स इट इज ऑल्सो ऑपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, सो इट विल बी माइनस 0.25 इंटू एन ए विच इज 20.81 इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन, इफ यू सी दिस इक्वेशन, वी हैव टू अननोन्स, टी इज ऑल्सो अननोन, टेंशन एंड एक्सेलरेशन इज ऑल्सो अननोन. Okay, so I'll simplify the equation. I'll get T minus 3A equal to minus 15.607. This is equation 1. Now observe block B. For block B, we don't have friction. Okay, so this I have shown FBD of block B. This is block B. Now this block B, it is being pulled in upward direction. Why? Because there is resistance to the motion of block B in downward direction because of this block A. Okay, so here you can draw arrows like this and cut it over here. So for block B, tension is in upward direction. Okay, we have seen this already in equilibrium. For inextensible string, tension acts away from the body and in the direction of rho. Okay, so tension is in the direction of rho and away from the body. So this is tension T. Now block, it is moving in downward direction. So acceleration is in downward direction. Inertia force will be in upward direction. What is the magnitude of inertia force? Mass into acceleration. Mass of block B is 5 kg. So 5 into acceleration. Okay, now what will be the weight of block B? It will be 5 into 9.81 in downward direction. Okay, so this is about FBD of block B. Okay, now we can apply D'Alembert's principle here. So summation of all the forces in y direction plus minus of mass into acceleration is equal to 0. Okay, now observe what is the direction of motion. Direction of motion, it is downward. So all the forces in downward direction we have to consider positive. Okay, so weight, it is acting in downward direction. So plus 5 into 9.81. Then tension is in upward direction. So minus T. And inertia force is also opposite. So minus 5A equal to 0. So in this equation also we have two unknowns, tension and acceleration. Okay, so tension T plus 5A is equal to 49.05. This is equation number 2. Now if you solve equation 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, we can get value of tension and acceleration. Okay, and both the things are asked in question. Okay, what is asked? Tension on the string and accelerations of A and B. Okay, so tension in the string T, it is equal to 8.639 Newton, and acceleration is equal to 8.082 meter per second square for both the blocks. Next question. Two masses of 60 Newton and 30 Newton are positioned over frictionless and massless pulley. So here you can see this is a pulley, this is frictionless and massless. Okay, now why frictionless is important over here? Because this rope, it is passing over the pulley. If friction is there, here you have to consider the friction force. Okay, that is why here what is given in the question, in this question we have to neglect that friction force over here. Okay, at this location. So two masses, 60 Newton, this is 60 Newton and this is 30 Newton, are positioned over frictionless and massless pulley. This is the pulley. If the 60 Newton mass is released from rest, so here you can see this 60 Newton mass, it is at a height of 2 meter. Okay, and this has been held at this position because of some force. Okay, now if you release this mass, what will happen? It will travel in downward direction and it will hit the ground. Okay, so what is asked in the question? If 60 Newton mass is released from the rest, this mass, find the speed at which 60 Newton mass will hit the ground. So we have to find velocity in this case. Now here what is given? Initially it is released from rest. Okay, so meaning B is at rest. Okay, what is meaning of that? U is equal to 0. And height is given over here. So we have value of S. Okay, so we have to use V square equal to U square plus 2AS. Now in this equation, we have to find V, U value is 0, 2A. Now this acceleration value we will get from D. Lambert's principle. And S value, it is 2 meter. Okay, so we have to calculate acceleration now. So we'll consider the FBD of block A and B. Now observe this diagram. I have shown FBD of block A and B. So here this is a block A which is having weight of 30 Newton. So this 30 Newton, it will act in downward direction. Okay. Now once this 60 Newton block is released, what will be the direction of motion? A will travel in upward direction and B will travel in downward direction. Okay, so acceleration of block A, it has been shown in upward direction. Direction of motion for block A is upward. So inertia force will be downward. What is the magnitude of inertia force? It is mass into acceleration. What is mass? Here weight is given. So convert weight into mass, divide by 9.81. So 30 divided by 9.81 into acceleration A. Okay, now here there will be tension. Okay, here this part, there will be tension in rope. Now, tension, it acts away from the body and in the direction of rope. Okay, one more approach which you can use is draw arrows like this and cut the rope over here. You will get the direction of tension. Okay, one more approach, what you can, how you can find the direction of tension is if you consider block B, it is traveling in downward direction. So block A, it is being pulled in upward direction. That is why tension is in upward direction. Okay, so this is about the tension part. So here we will have T, tension. So I'll consider block A first. For block A, using D. Lambert's principle, what I can write? Summation of force in y direction plus inertia force is equal to 0. Okay, now direction of motion is upward. So all the forces in upward direction we have to consider positive. So T will be plus. So plus T minus weight 30 Newton minus inertia force 30 upon 9.81 into A equal to 0. If you simplify this equation, you will get T minus 3.058 A is equal to 30. This is equation 1. Now we will see block B. Now block B, it is traveling in downward direction. Okay, so if block B is traveling in downward direction, acceleration is in downward direction. So inertia force will be in upward direction. Weight, it is acting in downward direction, it is 60 Newton downward direction, and inertia force, it will be mass into acceleration. How to get mass from Newton, from weight? So 60 divided by 9.81 into acceleration. Okay, so what about the direction of tension now? Understand the direction of tension. This is block B. Okay, again we have three ways in which we can decide the direction of tension. Draw arrow upward, downward, and cut the rope over here. So tension will be in upward direction. If you consider FBD of block B, this much part. Okay. Now understand that when I am saying FBD of block A, only this much part I have to draw. And when I say FBD of block B, I have to draw only this much part. No need to show this pulley arrangement. Okay. Now tension direction, I have told you one method. You can draw arrows like this, cut the rope over here. So tension will be in upward direction when you consider FBD of block. Second method, if this block is released from here, it is traveling in downward direction. Okay. And there is resistance to this rope. Why? Because this rope is being pulled in upward direction because of this mass. Okay, so that is why tension is in upward direction. One more method, tension in the string. It acts along the direction of string and away from the body. Okay, so in that way also you can show the tension in FBD. So this is about the FBD part. Now we will consider for block B, summation Fy plus inertia force equal to zero. Okay, so what is the direction of motion? Here you have to be careful. Direction of motion is downward. So downward forces we have to consider positive. Okay, so weight we are considering positive plus 60. Tension is in upward direction, so minus T, and inertia force, it is opposite to the direction of motion. Motion is downward, inertia force is upward. So it will be minus 60 upon 9.81 into A equal to 0. Now simplify this, you will get T plus 6.11 A equal to 60. This is equation number 2. Okay, now if you see equation 1 and equation 2, we have two equations and we have two unknowns. Okay, T is unknown and A is unknown. Okay, so solving 1 and 2, we can calculate T, tension in the string, it is equal to 40.05 Newton, and acceleration A is 3.27 meter per second square. Okay, now what is asked in the question? We have to find the speed at which 60 Newton mass, this mass B, will hit the ground. Okay, so initially it is at rest. So U is equal to 0. So what is the condition? U is equal to 0. Then acceleration we have calculated, it is 3.27 meter per second square, and displacement is 2 meter. It is given in the question. Okay, here you can see distance traveled by block B, it is 2 meter. Okay, so we have these values. We will use equation V square equal to U square plus 2As. We have to find V square. Okay, so V square equal to 0 plus 2 into 3.27 into 2. So we can calculate velocity. V is equal to 3.61 meter per second. So this is the velocity with which, this is the speed at which 60 Newton mass will hit the ground. Okay, so we have solved two numericals related to fixed pulley. Now we will solve numerical related to movable pulley. So problems on pulleys with movable centers. Two masses are interconnected with a pulley system. So here you can see mass 1 and mass 2, they are interconnected by pulley system. Neglecting frictional effect of pulleys and cord, determine the acceleration of mass m2. We have to find a2 value. Take m1 equal to 50 kg. So m1 is 50 kg and m2 40 kg. Now observe this. If you see pulley A, okay, this is movable pulley. It can move in upward direction, it can move in downward direction. Okay, so here I have written a statement. If pulley A moves up by x. Okay, if this pulley moves up by distance x, then 2x string will come down at M2. Why? Because this pulley on this side also there is x, this side is also there is x. So if pulley is moving in upward direction by x, 2x of the string will be free. Okay, so that is why if pulley A moves up by x, 2x string will come down at M2. Okay, so here there will be 2x string coming down. So same thing is written here, x, if this is upward, so right side this part there will be 2x downward direction. So what will be acceleration A1? It will be suppose A in upward direction. So what will be A2 in downward direction? A2 will be 2 times A. Why? Because here we have x, so acceleration will be A. But when we have 2x, acceleration will be 2A. So I have shown here FBD of block having mass M1. Okay, so this is block whose mass is M1. Motion is given over here. Okay, acceleration is in upward direction. So A1 is in upward direction. So motion of M1 mass, it is in upward direction. Okay, so weight will be in downward direction. What will be weight? It will be mass, which is 50 kg into g, 9.81. Then since M1 is moving in upward direction, inertia force will be in downward direction. What will be the magnitude of that inertia force? It will be 50 into acceleration. Okay, A1 we are considering A. So 50 into A. Now see the tension part. On this, this is the pulley. Okay, on this string, tension is T. Okay, and on this string, if you consider here, tension is T. So if you draw FBD of pulley, okay, on the top side you will be having T at this location and T at this location. So on the bottom side here also you will have 2T. Okay, now when you cut the rope over here, okay, you can see the direction. For FBD of block M1, tension will be 2T in upward direction. Okay, so how to draw the tension part in case of string? If you are drawing FBD of block having M1 mass, in that case tension is in the direction of rope and acting away from the body. Okay, so in this direction, and that tension, it is 2T. Okay, how 2T? I have explained over here, this is T and this is T, so 2T. Okay, so upward direction if it is 2T, here downward direction it will also be 2T, that is the reason. Okay, so we'll apply D'Alembert's principle now. So summation of forces in y direction plus inertia force equal to zero. Okay, now what is the direction of motion of block having mass M1? Upward. So upward forces we have to consider positive. Okay, so plus 2T minus 50 into 9.81 minus inertia force 50 into acceleration A1. Okay, this is equal to 0. So if you solve this equation, you will get 2T minus 50 A1 equal to 490.5. This is equation number 1. Now we will consider FBD of block having mass M2. So I have shown FBD of block having M2 mass. Okay, so understand this FBD. Acceleration direction A2, it is in downward direction given in question. So A2 is in downward direction. What is the mass of M2? 40 kg. Okay, so 40 into 9.81, that will be the weight of the block. Now tension in the string, we will see that part. So here tension is T. So here also that tension will be T only. Okay, so same rope is there, right? So in this rope, if here tension is T, here also tension will be T. Okay, now when we are considering FBD of block having mass M2, how to show the tension. Tension will act along the rope and away from the body. Okay, so this will be the direction of tension T. So T, it is in upward direction. So I have shown T in upward direction. Now direction of motion is downward. So inertia force, it will be in upward direction. Okay, what will be magnitude of inertia force? Mass into acceleration. Mass is 40 into acceleration is A2. Okay, so we have drawn FBD of block 2. Okay, so we can apply now D'Alembert's principle for block 2. Summation Fy plus inertia force equal to 0. Okay, now direction of motion is downward. So downward forces we have to consider positive. So upward forces will be negative. So minus T plus 40 into 9.81 minus inertia 40 into A2 equal to 0. So if you simplify this, T plus 40 A2 equal to 40 into 9.81. Now what is A2? It is 2 times A1. Okay, so we have to substitute that value. So T plus 80 A1 is equal to 392.4. This is equation 2 and this is equation 1. So you can compare these two equations. We have T as unknown and A1 is also unknown. So from 1 and 2 we can calculate tension T is equal to 280.28 Newton and acceleration A1 is equal to 1.401 meter per second square. Now acceleration A1, it is in which direction? Upward direction. So I'll show the direction of acceleration upward. But what is asked in the question? A2 is asked. Okay, I'll read the question. Determine the acceleration of mass m2. So we have to find A2 value. Okay, so what is A2? A2 is 2 times A1. So A2 is equal to 2 times A1. So A2 will be equal to 2.802 meter per second square. Now this acceleration direction is downward. This was asked in the question. So we will stop over here and continue with the remaining part in next lecture.